Let's say that we have a quarter circle and in it we have a full circle. Let's draw a line that is tangent to this full circle and is also perpendicular to the radius of the quarter circle. And let's say that that line has a length of 20. Now, can we calculate this red shaded area of the figure? You can pause this video right now if you want to try this one for yourself. Alright, let's get to the solution. Let us start by drawing the center of the circle, and from it we will draw the radius of the circle that will intersect the point where our tangent line touches the circle. We can mark this radius as R. Now we can mark the radius of the quarter circle as a big letter R. Now let us remind ourselves about the theory for the tangent of the circle. If you have a circle with a tangent and you draw a radius to the intersection point between the tangent and the circle, that radius will be normal to the tangent of the circle. We can use this theory in our case here, because our radius is also touching the tangent of the circle. So that means that the angle between them must be also 90 degrees. Now we can draw the full diameter of the circle, which would be equal to 2r. And we can slide it down to the bottom. Now let's take a look at this purple line, which represents the radius of our big quarter circle. We can rotate it so it intersects the point where our tangent line meets the quarter circle circumference. In this way, you can notice that we got this orange right triangle with the hypotenuse of big R and the legs of 2 small r and 20. Now we can use the Pythagorean theorem, which states that big R square is equal to 20 square plus 2 small r squared. We can work through this by saying that big R square is equal to 400 plus 4 small r square. And if we rewrite this, we will get that big R square minus 4 small r square is equal to 400. Now let's take a look at our shaded area. In order to find this shaded area, we first need to find the area of this quarter circle, and from it we will subtract the area of this inner full circle. So, if we put this into formula, we will get the following. Now, the area of the quarter circle must be equal to 1/4 of the big R square pi, and the area of this full circle will be equal to small r square pi. If we substitute these values in our previous equation, we will get that the shaded area is equal to 1/4 of the big R square pi minus small r square pi. Now we can take pi over 4 as a common factor, and we will be left with big R squared minus 4 small r squared. But if you noticed, we already got this section in our line number 3, and the value for this section is 400. So we can substitute that value instead. And that means that our area is equal to 100 pi, and if we substitute pi with 3.14, we will get that our area is approximately 314 squared units. And this is our solution. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a like and subscribe to the channel. Until next time, see you guys. Take care.